Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Midnight Oil. And the song that we are going to react to is Dreamworld. It will be our first time single take honest reaction to this Patreon request. We like making first time reactions. We haven't heard this song before, so it will be genuinely, truly, purely a first time listen for both of us. And we decide in the spur of the moment while listening to the song, what do we like about the song? Do we like it? Do we not like it? Does it connect with us? Does it not connect with us? Is it something completely opposite of our ethics, our values in life, or is it in line with it?
And also we make minute observations about the music, about the lyrics, things that we are used to doing in our everyday lives, whether as parents, teachers, counselors or life coaches. A part of our expertise lies in noticing things which most people don't notice that easily. And we've become pretty good at it, if I may say so. It may not sound modest me saying that, but the fact is we are. So we like making those observations because it helps us put things in perspective honestly, in a very honest and genuine manner for the viewers from across the world. Obviously, when we are asked through as an honest to the job of reacting to music as we are, we are not received well by the community at large. We will obviously have to sacrifice on views. We have sacrificed on millions of views on our videos. We made a lot of videos, more than 4,000 totally, 2,000 of them being online at this point in time. So we made a lot of videos and we should have had millions and millions of views in a month, but we don't. And the simple answer to that is not just because of our location and the algorithms on this platform, but mainly to do with us being honest reviewers. Obviously, when we are honest, we are not promoting the songs as other reactors do. So even if they've not heard it, even if they've heard it, irrespective of whether they've heard it, not heard it, their reactions are more or less 100% of the time the same, which is a positive, over-the-top, exaggerated, fake review. So when we are not like that, like them, like the typical reactor on YouTube, we have to sacrifice on views, we have to sacrifice on subscribers. A lot of fans don't like, you know, a review being negative or us saying, or anyone saying that they don't like the song they love. So I get that. As a music lover, I wouldn't like it. But at the same time, I know to appreciate those reactors. But unfortunately, on this platform, even that doesn't happen too often. Long story short, we are not going to change who we are, even though we get less views, less subscribers, less comments, less likes on our videos. We are not going to change. We are very, very content with going to a minuscule portion of YouTube's reach or potential reach. We are very, very happy. Very, very content. Because at the end of the day, Kirti and me, both of us, have to go to bed. We all sleep at night. Not just us two, but all those other reactors, all the viewers, everyone else in the comments, everyone has to sleep at night. That's when we get the safest, soundest, quietest sleep imaginable. Because we do our job to the best of our ability, staying true to our morals and ethical guidelines every single time.
Also, when it comes to Midnight Oil, what use is a reaction when you do not understand what the songs are about? And having a very little bit experience with Midnight Oil, I know they are very strong with their lyrics. Also, they like to take up social issues through their music. And most reactors, when they are exaggerated and they are over the top and they are only going to give fake reactions, there is very little opportunity for them to connect with the song that they are listening to, or to understand what exactly the song actually means to a person who should listen to it.
Yeah, let's get started. Sorry about the lengthy intro, but sometimes it's worth doing that because the couple of people who appreciate the hard work and the effort and the discipline we have, we are catering 100% of the time to those two people. So we are here for you. Just like we are two of us, we understand the importance of two more people who appreciate our honesty, our ethical guidelines, and keeping it raw through in the moment, impromptu every single time. Spontaneity, spontaneous every single time. We love unscripted reactions. You don't want to have a script. You don't want to do research. This is not our cup of tea. This is not what we like to do. And hopefully those two people are with us 100% of the way. That's why we've survived so long on this platform. Despite all the odds, we've survived. We are still here. And we'll continue to being here as long as we are healthy, as long as we are allowed to do so. We're here. That's it. Let's get started. Crashing down. This was absolutely brilliant. Well written, beautiful music. Wow. Just enjoyed listening to this. What are your thoughts, Kirti?
I like the way he sang it. I enjoyed the music as well. There was a lot going on in the music. And as far as the lyrics are concerned, I think it is supposed to be again a social cause project or something that the song is taking up at not for Norfolk Islands. I've heard of it, but I'm not really sure at this moment, on the spot, the location of it, the right location of it. But I've heard of this island, somehow from somewhere, Norfolk Island. It's talking about some project that is coming and it will be changing the dream world of the people who are around it, who are in the natural beauty of this place, and probably all of that is coming to an end. Everything is falling down, all the dreams are going to fall and end, because the place will be changed and it will turn into something commercial. And that happens. That happens with a lot of locations on our planet. Almost every single day there is something or the other happening all around the world in the name of progress, in the name of development. Sometimes for good, sometimes not for good for the people, but for the good for the business and enterprise or the industry that benefits, not the people at large. It has this subject has two sides, as usual, two sides to the coin. Sometimes it is actually good for the locals and good for the people when something good happens, because they can be brought out of poverty, they can have better life just like everybody else around and everybody else in other parts of the country. But at times it is not for their benefit, and it's only for the benefit of the business person that is coming there and just going to take away their freedom and their land forever. So it goes case by case, I say. It's not always this side or that side. It always goes case by case. In India, most people, I would say, not just one, two people, most people are very nature conscious, are very environmental conscious people. They understand the value of nature. They know when it hurts the nature, when the environment can be damaged, when the ecosystem can be damaged. And people do businesses or work according to that. That is the reason why we have such a huge population, yet we are not one of the biggest pollutants of this planet. The biggest pollutants are from elsewhere, because we are in our daily life also very, very careful and very, very cautious. And some people who aren't, they are only because they aren't, it's not that they are ignorant, because they are unaware what effect it may have on them. So people understand it is a direct ill effect on us if we damage the environment. Not this is not the case in all countries, I would say, or in every person. Everybody just thinks of making some bucks or making money on things, even at the cost of ruining the future in the attempt of doing that.
Yeah, I look at it in a different way, because Kirti has more or less covered everything what I wanted to speak about. Okay. I love the vocals, I love the music, I love the depth of the music. It was wonderful how they all come together and say end and fall, those two words. It was just brilliantly done. You know, if you look at it as far as this Wuhan coronavirus pandemic is concerned, that first started in China, at least that's what we all know, and then spread to the whole world. People are dying, people are crippled with it, people are infected with it. When I say crippled, means their entire lives are affected, like us, like yours probably, due to the lockdown, due to everything put at a standstill, at a halt, everything is at a halt, a full stop. If you look at it that way also, we never really predicted it. Nobody expected it to be like this. And that's why what I take out of this song is, don't get too comfortable wherever you are. If you're in Eden, if you're in the Garden of Eden, if you're in paradise, like the person seemed to be in this place where it was like the Garden of Eden, if you're in a place that's as beautiful as that, if you're happy with where you are, don't take it for granted. Because things can change in that particular location, that particular city, that particular country in an instant. The area we live in Mumbai is sealed. We can't leave this area unless if it's a medical emergency. And neither can anyone come in unless they're coming for that medical emergency. So that's how it is right now in this area where we live in Mumbai. So we didn't really expect that. We never expected there would be a day where we are actually barricaded on all four sides in our area. But that's how life is. So I've learned due to the pandemic, due to songs like that, and I'm very grateful to patrons who request songs like that, because it puts our lives in perspective. You know, any form of music that is not just interesting and entertaining, but also thought-provoking, relevant and meaningful to our lives is great music, in my opinion. So I absolutely love this song. That's it for this one. Check out our Patreon page. The link is in the description box of the video. You'll learn a bit more about us. Especially if it's your first time here and you don't know who we are, that will help.